West Ham come out to defend what's currently the longest unbeaten run in the Football League. They haven't lost a league game since Boxing Day 1980, a run of 24 matches without defeat. And that success is reflected in another big crowd. West Ham are the only league club whose gates have actually improved over the last three seasons. Well, a settled side is the key to success in football, and this lineup has figured in all six games so far. It means there's no place for Trevor Brooking, now fit again after injury, and Paul Brush is named the substitute in case centre-half Alvin Martin suffers a reaction to an ankle injury he collected in the victory over Southampton on Tuesday. Well, the star of that win was Paul Goddard, whose hat-trick makes him the First Division's leading scorer with a total of six goals. Liverpool also won in midweek, their victory at Coventry providing them with their first away points of the season. And not surprisingly, they keep an unchanged side to defend a fine record at Upton Park, where Liverpool have lost only once in their last eight visits. Liverpool's substitute is Mark Lawrenson, who's failed to win back his place following a two-match suspension. And a familiar face in the stands, England manager Ron Greenwood, and after the pressures of England's problems, it'll make a nice change to be a spectator today. The referee, Portsmouth's Alan Robinson, and it'll be Liverpool to kick off, attacking from right to left, Liverpool in a new all-yellow strip. Phil Neal, and another England man, Phil Thompson, Liverpool's last visit to Upton Park, incidentally, in 1978. And the 2-0 success they gained that day sent West Ham into the second division. Robillard looking for Johnson, but easy for Alvin Martin. That's gone on. On to Pike. Stewart forward. And a good ball too, because Neighbour has the pace to reach it before Alan Kennedy. And cross and Goddard in the middle. Alan arriving quickly. Not a back cross. Robillard's fist away, but the referee had already spotted offside. Interesting break that by West Ham. A good ball down the right for Jimmy Neighbour, and his cross might have had Liverpool in trouble. Robillard fisting away, but the whistle had already sounded. Souness. Liverpool have four men forward in this attack. Oh, a superb save! And what a fine effort too by Kenny Dalglish. Dalglish had four men forward on the edge of the box, but saw a gap, went for it, and that powerful right foot shot seemed to be speeding for the top corner till Parks flicked it over. Lee, Neal is there again, still three men in the middle. Neal will have to chase, and does well. Again, Dalglish was almost on the end of that cross. Here's David Johnson. Ray Kennedy, good early pressure by Liverpool. And West Ham themselves taking time to settle. Good skill by Jimmy Miller. Here's Stewart. And Pike. Neighbour. Pike continued his run. The pass was slightly overhit. Alan Hansen for Liverpool. Dermot, Souness, an intricate pattern in midfield. Dalglish turning away from defenders so well. Here's Johnson. Breaks kindly for Ray Kennedy. And this is good football by Liverpool in the early stages. Alan Kennedy. Johnson could be on the end of this, and really West Ham nearly paid the price then for ball watching. As the cross came over from the left, David Johnson had sneaked in behind the defenders, but the header directed the ball wide instead of on target. There's Devonshire, and cross. Good defence by Neal. Lampard, Alan short for him, Lee making it difficult. West Ham's persistence pays off. Here's Stewart. Oh, and very nearly a goal there for David Cross. Stewart spotted Cross making a good run in the centre forward position, He hit that ball really powerfully along the ground. Both Grobbelaar and Cross committed themselves, and in the end the ball went wide. Souness. Johnson. And now Lee. Neil. Ooh, and again the final Liverpool through ball, nearly deceiving West Ham. And Billy Bonds just can't find his touch at all. A few moments ago he gave the ball straight to Kenny Dalglish, and now with what appeared a very easy back pass to Phil Parks, he's given Liverpool a corner. Well, Kennedy in a forward position, Dalglish is on the goal line. Lee's corner. Johnson's header, here's Dalglish. Oh, well, it just won't go for Kenny Dalglish. Beautiful positioning by Parks. Ray Kennedy finding McDermott. Well, the photographer can enjoy the challenge. I bet that that man did. In, sees a space. One's made a good run. Links with Cross. Good tackle by Plank. Now Lampard. Billy Bonds. Well, who will want to forget this first half, the West Ham skipper. And there's danger here because Lee is the extra man. Liverpool's right. Dalglish finds him. And again, Parks really making up for the errors by the men in front of him. And poor Billy Bonds in particular has given the ball away four times and under no real pressure. Here's Neighbour. And Allen. And nobody out there on the left for him. So he comes right for Stewart. Devonshire made a very good run then. In the box, couldn't make room for the cross, but settles for the corner. This time's first corner kick of the half then. Ballard, another danger man. There's Pike, Stewart, her neighbour rather. And the ball comes to Pike. What a superb goal by Jeff Pike. It all stemmed from the corner earned by Devonshire. Liverpool seemed to have got it clear, but as it fell to Pike, he spotted the tiniest of gaps between Grobbelaar and the post, and that hammered right foot shot did the rest. West Ham 1, Liverpool 0, against the run of play maybe, but no one in the West Ham crowd is complaining about that. Deadly finishing by Jeff Pike, his second goal of the season. Liverpool hit back quickly with Dalglish. Well, Jeff Pike will be celebrating his birthday on Monday. He's 25, and what a marvellous way to make it a memorable weekend. Crosses header. There's Thompson. And Neil. Kennedy, Souness wanting it played quickly to him, finds Dalglish, Bonds and Lampard, putting themselves in a little bit of a tangle, which Stewart extricates them from. Here's Ray Kennedy, now Dalglish, Ray Kennedy, and a game for Ray Kennedy, oh! Well, Liverpool was so unlucky then. West Ham had so many players behind the ball, but Dalglish and Ray Kennedy combined superbly with that 1-2, and the shot in the air from Ray Kennedy striking the foot of the post and being cleared for a corner. Dalglish takes the kick. It's Devonshire who clears. leash again. The linesman deciding that Devonshire had charged in. Here's Graham Souness again, West Ham retreating. And really fumble. Joe Parks was always confidently behind that. Ray Kennedy now. Dalglish. Dermot's made a run, but the half-time whistle brings that attack to an end. And although Liverpool dominated in terms of attacking, they hit the post, they saw Parks make a marvellous save. It's all about finishing, of course, and West Ham had in Jeff Pike the man who could finish better than anybody in the Liverpool side in that first half. Pike number 11, one of the overlooked players so often in this West Ham side, but the star of the first half, which ends West Ham 1, Liverpool 0. So West Ham start the second half, confident of extending a home record, which now stretches to 23 games without defeat. The last team to win here was Luton Town on the opening day of last season. But they really will have to keep possession more than they did in the first half, and they gave the ball to Liverpool so often. Dermot being beaten by Paul Allen. And again. Taking an age with the throw. And finally, it's Billy Bonds who nicks in and takes it from Kenny Dalglish. And now Goddard. Hansen's interception. Neil now for Liverpool. Johnson is wide on the left and Lee wide on the right. Here's Ray Kennedy. Souness. Dalglish chasing, but Bonds reads that. And again, though he made it, he won't be terribly happy with the clearance, which gives Liverpool a corner. Once again, Phil Thompson, the Liverpool skipper, coming forward. And five men in the box. Thompson's header. Up to Dalglish. Stewart missed kicking. Oh, well, Sammy Lee then was gifted an opening. As the corner came over, Ray Stewart completely missed kicking and slicing it straight to Sammy Lee, who looked shocked more than anything and really ought to have done better from that position. Thompson. Sammy Lee for Liverpool. Dermot and Johnson on the edge of the box, so is Ray Kennedy. Souness finds him. And fine ball to Alan Kennedy. West Ham again getting behind the ball so well. Here's Dalglish in the deflection. He's taken the ball over the line for another corner. And Liverpool have enjoyed so much pressure in this game, but still they trail by a goal to nil. Dalglish with the corner. Oh, Parks missed it completely. And they just about get it away. Still not. Souness. Lee. The danger not gone yet, perhaps it has now from Lampard's clearance. And in fact it has now because David Johnson was in an offside position. But amazingly, Phil Parks, who had played so well in the first half, hadn't really put a foot wrong, completely missing that cross, and West Ham lucky that they weren't made to pay more dearly for that mistake. His first of the game, it has to be said. Alvin Martin. A good deal taller than Goddard. Stewart a good deal stronger than Ray Kennedy. Running loose to Goddard. Here's Pike again. It was so close to number two. West Ham more determined in midfield. They won two important tackles. Pike took on the Liverpool defence and the shot looked as though it might creep in the corner. In the end it was just wide. Famous bubble song floating around this ground. Dalglish for Liverpool. Very nearly ran for McDermott. Stewart defending excellently again. soonest now for Liverpool. Here's Phil Neal. McDermott, the space just wouldn't open up. And credit to West Ham for that. Soonest looking for Johnson this time. Johnson is climbing on the back of Lampard. That's a free kick to West Ham. Pike always so eager to receive possession. Lampard. Haddad holding off Hansen's challenge. Well, he could be in here. Well, it was an intelligent effort. Again, Pike involved in the build-up for West Ham. Goddard, good control as he held off the Liverpool defender, Hansen behind him. Made the space for a shot, more of a chip in the end, and not far off target. Ray Kennedy, it's Johnson on the left. And Johnson was using his elbow then on Alvin Martin. Well, he doesn't appear to agree. Hansen's header. Someone's thinking the ball had gone off the West Ham man. Thompson for Liverpool. There's Neal. Souness. Controlling it beautifully, finding Johnson. McDermott and Lee inside the penalty area. Here's McDermott, and there's Lee, and in the end it was Paul Allen who arrived to belt the ball away. A dangerous attack there, but Johnson doing well down the left for Liverpool. The ball squirming through defenders' legs. And it's Paul Allen's clearance that's given Liverpool this corner. Easy header away for Martin. And what can West Ham do now on the break? Devonshire. Pike. Devonshire again. And finding Neighbour in good space. Stewart going on the overlap for him. He finds Goddard, who's onside. Oh, and a fine piece of goalkeeping by Drobbelaar. It's a good ball to set up Goddard down the right, and that ball driven in from that to wing produced an acrobatic piece of goalkeeping from Drobbelaar. Here's Thompson though for Liverpool. Hansen. And Souness. And again, so many yellow Liverpool jerseys forward. He got to the line well. Parks drops it and Johnson heads the equaliser. Well, for the umpteenth time, Liverpool coming forward, and Parks, who's played so well, has gifted them a goal. Alan Kennedy doing well to get to the touchline, pulled his cross back well. It looked like Phil Parks' ball. He had it, let it slip from his grasp, and David Johnson headed in the easiest goal he'll score this season. West Ham 1, Liverpool 1, and although the goal came about in very fortunate fashion, I don't think anyone can argue that Liverpool didn't deserve to equalise. Perhaps that's set up now an exciting final 10 minutes, as both teams, we hope, go in search of the three-point incentive that will come their way if they win. Because frankly, we're a game between two quality sides. We haven't seen the sort of match that we had expected. McDermott for Liverpool. A little over 10 minutes to go. And Thompson, this time retreating again in the face of this wave of Liverpool players. Here's Ray Kennedy. Again, the defenders back away. And Kennedy's left-foot shot off target. Paisley, well, I was going to say looking a little happier now. He still looks a little bit disappointed with things. The Liverpool chairman, John Smith, on his right as we watch. Donald's header, and he was being fouled by Hansen from behind. Stewart's free kick. Oh, Grobbelaar's come and missed it completely. And how lucky Liverpool are to get away with a corner. Still not giving Liverpool problems. Here's Neighbour. Bond's going up for it, and David Cross was so close to the winner. Swinging centre from the right seemed to catch the Liverpool defenders a little flat-footed. And David Cross just swung his boot at it, really, and saw it go wide. Here's Lampard. Under pressure from David Johnson. Oh, and Thompson didn't see Cross coming round the back. Can he get in? Good save by Grobbelaar. Well, Phil Thompson then was slightly slow to realise that David Cross was coming round the outside. Cross reached the ball, Grobbelaar reacted very quickly and made a good block. Now for Liverpool, the referee has looked at his watch and it looks as though both sides will have to settle for a point as Hansen finds Dalglish. Liverpool still intent on the 3 points if they can get them, but the final whistle from Mr. Robertson signals the end to a match that I suppose from two such quality footballing sides was disappointing, but I think more blame attaches for that to West Ham than Liverpool. Surprisingly for them, they seem to sit back and contain Liverpool, and in the end they paid the price as David Johnson, number 9 there, headed in an easy goal following Phil Park's mistake to rule out the goal scored by Jeff Pike, one of the game's outstanding players in the first half. But West Ham remain unbeaten. The final score at Upton Park, West Ham 1, Liverpool 1. Thank you.